Everyone grows up dreaming of living in outer space. We all want to get inside a spaceship and reach for the stars. Let me show you how we can do this. Let's turn your childhood dreams into your children's future. First, let's take on a trip across space. We're going toward Saturn's biggest moon, Titan. Titan is bigger than Mercury and is able to sustain life unlike any other planet or moon in our solar system. We can build a colony in Titan in the next century. All we need is more funding from the United States government to NASA for outer space programs to fulfill our dreams and hopes of colonizing space. Today, the United States government spends less than 0.5% of its national budget in space exploration. NASA's $17 billion pales compared to the Security Department's $757 billion spent each year. That's 47 times bigger. These are worrying signs of the death of deep space exploration programs. After reaching the moon under the leadership of President Kennedy, we have lost the drive and the interest to keep moving forward. Humanity is moving at a breathtaking pace. 100 years ago, we had no jet airplanes, and the only way to get across the Atlantic was in a ship. 50 years ago, when we were able to reach the moon, we had no smartphones, no self-driving cars, no Facebook, no Instagram. Today, we have all those things. Imagine where we will be in 5, 50, or even 100 years from now. President Kennedy said that it was our choice to go to the moon, and we can choose to go to Titan. The probability of a successful mission to Titan is hard to estimate. But if we never try, then the answer is zero. The journey towards Titan begins with Congress accepting NASA's request of a budgetary increase of $18.5 billion for the year 2016. Next, Congress needs to spend more than 0.5% of its budget in NASA. The idea is to increase the budget to at least 2%. The level that it was in 1960 when the US managed to land in the moon. Third, missions to Mars and asteroids need to continue to be developed in the next 20 to 50 years. After this, the first steps towards Titan will be in place to help all of humanity. If we could colonize Titan, we could take advantage of its Earth-like atmosphere and its deep and vast mineral resources for the advent of humanity. Airspace engineer Dr. Robert Zubrin says, "In certain ways, Titan is the most hospitable planet within our solar system for human colonization. Titan has water and enough natural minerals to create food fertilizers. The financial benefits of colonizing Titan are gigantic. The mineral deposits in the moons of Saturn and the asteroids around it are more than anything we have here. Not only a Titan colony will expand humanity's reach into outer space, it will bring gigantic economic benefits as well. The United States government has to provide NASA with more funds for outer space exploration." Beyond building a future for our children, increasing funding for NASA's mission to Titan will bring us new inventions to our lives. The challenges of such a mission will push NASA's engineers to keep developing new technologies. Marvels like the microchip, solar energy panels, and long-distance communications were invented by NASA. Just imagine what they could do with more funding. To write letters to your senators, talk to your friends and family about NASA and its programs, and be as active as you can to help us reach our dream, to help us get to Titan